When I started DOC, or Doctors Auto Care, in 1977, the goal was to purchase counter-advertising space in the mass media to laugh the tobacco industry and other pushers of unhealthy products out of town. And we specifically wanted to focus on brand name ridicule, but we couldn't find a medium that would take our ads. Billboard companies refused to take any kind of parodies of cigarette ads, and we didn't have very much money. And as I drove around Miami, I saw lots and lots of bus benches by the side of the road. And I asked around, and the people in advertising, what do you think of bus benches? And every single person said, oh, don't do bus benches. Nobody sees bus benches. Well, I still wanted to visit the company, and I met a fellow called Jack Waxenberg at Bus Benches Company. And he showed me that for a very modest fee, we could have our choice of locations. And it was about $24 a month for so many months. And he even said that they would design what we were looking for. And one of the early slogans we wanted to do was to spoof Marlboro Country. So we did Country Fresh Arsenic. These bus benches, this was one of the ones that he gave me, a miniature one that he printed up. We had on 30 bus benches all over Miami for over a year. They attracted attention all over the world. As a result of just putting these bus benches, people got the idea that even small advertising budgets could attract attention. In fact, the first article on the bus bench was an outraged letter that led to an article on the Key Biscayne, in the Key Biscayne paper about, are these bus benches legal? Do they have licenses? Are they allowed to advertise like that? But it got controversy, and people started noticing bus benches even more. Jack Waxenberg and I became good friends, and he was so pleased that he was able to help launch perhaps the first paid anti-smoking advertising effort in the United States on bus benches.